Japan is a land of fertile soil and abundant water. Wasabi is an ingredient unique to Japan that was created by the blessings of nature. The second it's on your tongue, it produces a sharp taste and refreshes the mouth. Especially for sushi, sashimi, and soba noodles, wasabi is absolutely indispensable. Cultivating wasabi is very difficult and labor-intensive. The knowledge gained by earlier generations has been passed down through the years. Fish has long been eaten raw in Japan, and wasabi was what made that possible. Nowadays, wasabi is also in the international spotlight, and it's used in a variety of cuisines. Furthermore, new non-food uses of wasabi are being researched. On this edition of Begin Japanology, our theme is wasabi. We look at the appeal and history of this special ingredient that grew out of Japan's climate and culture.
Hello and welcome to Begin Japanology. I'm Peter Barragan. In front of me I have a dish of soba, buckwheat noodles, and wasabi, which is the theme of our program today, is something that you absolutely must have if you're going to have a meal of soba. Now, uninitiated heathens like myself, and quite a lot of Japanese for that matter too, will dissolve ground wasabi into the dipping sauce for the soba. But people who know about these things will tell you that, in fact, the noodles taste better if you put the wasabi directly onto them and then dip the noodles into the dipping sauce. And then you know, they're right. The tartness of the wasabi kind of spreads throughout your mouth without being diluted by the sauce. Okay, I'm gonna eat some more of this. Let's move on now and take a look at a video and learn some more about wasabi.
These days, sushi is familiar around the world. Slices of fresh fish on rice. Wasabi is an essential element of this traditional Japanese food. It adds a little extra zest to the sushi experience. It plays second fiddle, but takes center stage for a moment with that strong initial impact. Sushi without wasabi definitely lacks something. Sushi chefs call wasabi teardrops because it packs such a punch when you first taste it. Moments later, it refreshes the palate and enhances the experience of eating sushi. Wasabi goes with much more than just fish-based dishes like sushi and sashimi. This is chazuke. Rice is topped with ingredients including wasabi, and green tea is poured on top. The refreshing aroma stimulates the appetite. The scientific name for wasabi is Wasabia japonica. It's native to Japan. The stem, called the rhizome, is grated and eaten. They say the taste of wasabi depends on how it's grated. This grater is made from shark skin. The tough, tiny bumps are what enables this type of grater to effectively bring out the aroma and pungency of wasabi. It's best to start grating the wasabi stem from the top, near the leaves. This is the freshest part of the stem and makes the best grated wasabi in both taste and color. You grate steadily, moving in circles. If you bite off a chunk of wasabi, it tastes bitter and lacks punch. But when you grate it, the wasabi cells break down and internal elements react to oxygen, creating that distinctive impact. Soon after wasabi's been grated, the impact will start to fade. It becomes softer and mellower. I believe that grating it in full view of a customer shows off its freshness, and the tanginess and fragrance are improved. For tuna eaten as sashimi and so on, it's definitely best to grate wasabi in front of the diner. The leaves and flowers of wasabi are sometimes eaten as well. Let's look at how to make sambaizuzuke pickles using wasabi shoots. First, wash the shoots. Then knead them with salt to soften them. Now put a weight on top to squeeze out the scum that has formed. After about an hour, wash off the scum and salt and drain the water. Add sambaizu made from vinegar, sugar and soy sauce. Then seal the mixture closely and leave it in the fridge for a few days. These sambaizuzuke wasabi shoots are crunchy and taste great, combining pungency, sweetness and sourness. This is wasabizuke, leaves and stems marinated in sake leaves. If you heat wasabi, the flavor disappears, so it's mostly used raw in cooking. Wasabi leaf tempura is served at the start of spring, when the leaves are said to taste the best. Wasabi livens up the Japanese dinner table, usually in a supporting capacity to enhance the taste of other foods, but occasionally playing the leading role.
We have a number of wasabi-derived products here. Wasabi-flavored soft ice cream, that was a first for me, and wasabi-flavored beer too. This is a croquette with some wasabi inside, and wasabi-flavored potato chips, or crisps as I would call them. I've got to try this ice cream, I can't believe. Where's the wasabi? Very, very faint flavor. Looks really nice though. Wasabi is a plant that's unique to Japan. It's a member of the Brassica family. Now, another member of that family is horseradish. Horseradish is considerably bigger than wasabi. It's also harvested in much less time, typically 7 to 8 months, and it's cultivated in ordinary fields. In contrast, wasabi is grown for typically 1.5 to 2 years, and sometimes even longer than that. I'm going to try grating up a little of both of them now and compare the tastes. First of all, let's do the wasabi. Just a little will do. It's really fresh. It's pungent. It hits the roof of your mouth with a sort of direct hit there. Now, let's do the same thing with some horseradish here. It's similar, not quite as strong as the wasabi, and not quite as pungent either. But you can tell that they are plants from the same genus. Interesting. Wasabi has a unique taste, and even when grown in other countries, it's difficult to get the same flavor. That's because wasabi is the result of conditions that are only found in Japan. Let's take a look now at the relationship between wasabi and Japan's climate and land.
Japan is a mountainous land of abundant water. Since ancient times, scenery has been called sansui, meaning mountains and water. All over Japan, water and mountains are key components in countless scenes of natural beauty. Three quarters of Japan is mountainous, and the country gets a lot of snow and rain. A huge amount of water accumulates in the mountains. This abundant water filters into valleys and eventually flows down as mountain streams. Water seeps into the mountain soil, absorbs natural minerals, and becomes bubbling spring water. Crystal clear water created by the mountains. Wasabi, a plant unique to Japan, is closely bound to this natural abundance. Izu, a city in Shizuoka Prefecture. Here they cultivate wasabi using a traditional method, wasabi paddies. Wasabi grows naturally in mountainous areas. And here, it's being cultivated in the heart of the mountains. Wasabi cultivation is very time-consuming. It's hard work even to get to the paddies here. The farmers climb up an unpaved path for over half an hour, taking crates with them on a rail. In these paddies, about 100,000 wasabi seedlings are planted in terraces in the valley. Why are they cultivated in such an inconvenient spot? Wasabi is a very delicate plant. It won't grow well unless all sorts of conditions are met. First is the temperature. Wasabi won't grow if it's either too hot or too cold. Cool mountainous areas where temperature variations through the year are not too extreme are best. It's also important to have the right amount of sunshine. To grow well, wasabi needs 30% sunshine and 70% shade. Valleys like this, offering the right amount of shade, are well suited to cultivation. But the most important thing in wasabi cultivation is water. You need a great deal of pure water. Wasabi absorbs nutrients from the water. If the water is dirty, the wasabi soon becomes unhealthy. These wasabi paddies are fed by water bubbling up from a bed of volcanic rock. The mountain soil filters the water, giving it a high mineral content. Since water management is critical for wasabi, there's a lot of work right from when you start planting it. Wasabi cultivators actually have a special way to keep the water really clean, the stone mat style, which involves piling up stones and rocks. Wasabi paddies are surrounded by stone walls, and underneath the paddies, there are big rocks laid at the bottom and smaller stones piled on top. The topmost layer is highly permeable sand. The water filters through the sand and stones and flows into the paddies below. This means the water in the wasabi paddies is always kept clean. The farmers make sure that the temperature of the water remains at about 13 degrees Celsius year-round. Wasabi sprouts one leaf after another as it grows. It takes a long time to reach a good size, from 1 to 2 years. The marks on the surface of wasabi are scars where the leaves came off. The space between the scars reveals how the stem will taste. Wide spaces mean growth was too fast. The taste will be watery and weak. Narrow spaces represent slow growth. the pungency will be overpowering. And this is the ideal spacing. A top-notch wasabi can sell for more than 5,000 yen. One of the most labor-intensive aspects of growing wasabi is maintaining the paddies. In heavy rains, rocks can become dislodged, blocking the water flow. In places like this, where machines can't get in, the rocks have to be moved by hand. You can harvest wasabi all year round. Its special taste comes from such natural blessings as fertile land and clear water. But another key factor is the unstinting efforts of many people.
I'm now in Azumino, which is in Nagano Prefecture to the west of Tokyo. It's an area known for its beautiful water. Water from snow melting in the Japan Alps seeps into the ground and then bubbles up into these wasabi paddies that you can see behind me. Wasabi here is produced on flat land. It's a rather unusual method, which is rarely adopted elsewhere, but more wasabi is produced here than in any other place in Japan. However, the conditions here are more difficult than in the mountains, because Azumino has cold winters and hot summers, and because it's flat, there's no shade. So the wasabi has to be covered with cloth during the winter and the summer. In winter to keep off the cold, and in summer to create some shade. Wasabi can be harvested all year round, and I'm told that some of the plants down here are just about ready for harvesting now, and here are the guys working. Whoa, it's actually quite deep down here. Is there any special way to pull the wasabi out?
This one here, I pulled it out earlier. You see, these leaves are edible, so you have to be careful not to damage them. Now try pulling this one out.
Okay, this is a big one. So, and you have to pull it out not too hard, but firmly but gently. Here we go. Whoa, that's quite a big one. Okay, and then you have to rinse off. You have to hold it on the bottom. God, it's cold. How long have these been growing?
About 16 months. Now's the right time to harvest them.
I've heard that the taste of the wasabi can differ depending on what time of the year it's harvested.
The growth of wasabi pretty much ceases during the cold months, and that's when the flavor becomes deeper and richer. I think wasabi is at its tastiest in winter.
Okay, while I dry off and warm my hands a little bit, let's go back and look at the history of how Japanese people came to eat and love wasabi.
This is an archaeological site dating back to around the 7th century. In 2001, unusual strips of wood with characters written on them were discovered here. This one says wasabi. Other strips of wood bore names of medicinal herbs. So it seems that from at least the 7th century, wasabi was being used as a medicine. Wasabi grew wild in the mountains of Japan. It was first cultivated during the early Edo period, 400 years ago, probably in what is now Shizuoka Prefecture. Tokugawa Ieyasu, the first Edo shogun, put strict controls on wasabi cultivation. Wasabi was a highly prized item. These are volumes of a food dictionary from that period. The entries include a record of how to use wasabi. It describes wasabi's anti-toxic effects when used with fish or chicken. The entry says wasabi cheers the spirits, stimulates perspiration, and cures colds. But later, in the early 19th century, wasabi became an everyday feature of Japan's food culture. This was when people began to enjoy eating fresh, uncooked fish, the start of Edo-style sushi. Many sushi shops opened and were very popular. The use of wasabi made a great difference to the pleasure of eating raw fish. Another reason that wasabi spread was the emergence of tuna as a popular dish. With its high fat content, tuna doesn't keep long, so originally people didn't eat it much. But in 1854, there was an exceptionally good catch. Sushi shops came up with the idea of preserving tuna in soy sauce, and thus created zuke. With wasabi added, zuke was a smash hit in Edo, the city that later became Tokyo. The combination of fresh fish, soy sauce, and wasabi became an essential feature of the Edo diet. Wasabi was also added to soba noodles. It was first used to counter the fishy smell of bonito soup stock. And now wasabi is loved as an essential item with raw fish. The pungency in your mouth, the heat, and then the refreshing way it races through your nose. A lot of Japanese people just love that. And that's why it's been passed on to this day. Wasabi ensured that fish was safe to eat and brought out its flavor. And that's why it gained popularity in a country that loves raw fish.
Everyone knows how much the Japanese like to eat raw fish, but back in the days before refrigeration, there was always a danger of food poisoning, so people had to find a safe way to enjoy their fish. And very early on, they must have understood that both soy sauce and wasabi have antiseptic qualities. Also, Japanese people like anything that reminds them of nature. And when you eat wasabi, the taste of it brings to mind mountains and water and a faint scent of grass. That may be another reason for its popularity. These days, there are new ways of enjoying wasabi being tried out both in Japan and elsewhere. Let's take a look.
With the global boom in healthy Japanese food, wasabi has become well known internationally. It's used not only in Japanese cooking, but also in Western dishes. This French restaurant uses a sauce that combines wasabi and flying fish roe. Wasabi is even being cultivated abroad. 13 years ago, experimental cultivation began on the island of Tasmania in Australia, with the aim of developing wasabi as a new local product. Blessed with a cool climate and plenty of water, Tasmania resembles the mountainous areas of Japan. But it was tough to grow high-quality wasabi. In fact, it took 4 years to prepare the first shipment. Wasabi is very delicate. You can't get good wasabi if the sun's too strong or if it's too warm. A new idea is being tried in Tasmania, adding wasabi to locally produced cheese. I would never have imagined that Japanese wasabi and our cheese would be such a great match. Meanwhile, in Japan, there are various non-food uses of wasabi. Wasabi's antibacterial properties are used to make these sheets that stop boxed lunches from spoiling. Boxed lunches are very common in Japan. A lot of people take a homemade box lunch to work or to school, or away on a trip. So the use of wasabi to prevent spoiling is a very welcome development. Been in practical use since 2009. Wasabi has been used in Japan since ancient times, but it seems it still has untapped potential.
Wasabi has been used as medicine in Japan since long ago. Recently, research is being conducted into what it is that gives it its effect. The aim being to identify possible uses in the prevention of cancer, diabetes, and even anti-aging. But if wasabi is to continue to be a vital crop into the future, it's going to be equally vital to preserve the natural conditions which allow it to grow. I'll see you again next time.